Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Star Wars The Old Republic Let's Play. I've been running the mercenary storyline, and I figured I'd change it up just a little bit by playing a Flashpoint for you. Flashpoint is a type of a mission you can go on with other player characters. This one is the Hammer Station Flashpoint. There are other characters, three other characters on this mission with me. I have the chat window closed right now, so I don't get bombarded with people talking or texting while I'm playing. Look at that teamwork.
Intruders detected. Hammer Station security online. Lockdown in progress.
One thing to note for these flashpoints, that when you're doing them in a veteran mode like myself, we are all stepped up to level 70. But I'm still kind of limited by the skills I have, because my character is only level 24, and the modifications I have on my armor are limited, of course, because, well, they're level based also. Gotta heal up here. Now we're drawing back the enemies around the corner to where we are. Make it a little easier for us to kill them all grouped up together. Just spam area of effect damage. Looks like three of us are actual bounty hunters. And the other one with the little blue lightning bolt is either a sorcerer or an assassin. But since it's a single-bladed lightsaber, I'm going to say they're a sorcerer. Oh, there I go. I returned to the start because it was really towards the beginning of the mission to respawn. Otherwise, somebody would have to resurrect me where we are. And I want to say, I think that takes away their ability to resurrect somebody in the future if we need it. A lot of times when I play this Hammer Station mission, a lot of people use it for a speed run, so they run through it as fast as they possibly can, just destroying everything, skipping a lot of enemies. It doesn't seem to be the case this time. We're sort of taking our time, looks like. The character that is blue-skinned, I want to say, is a Chiss. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that right. And then the reddish-skinned one is the Sith race. Pureblood Sith. Taking a shortcut here, otherwise we'd have to run around a little bit, fight some more enemies. Luckily somebody had the skill to use that little drill there and get us through to this first, I guess you would consider it like a boss.
Our jealous rivals would destroy our great weapon. But today, the Admiral's hegemony...
Not too much strategy involved with fighting this boss. Just spam it. The little blue-looking glowy machine things on the ground around it are like Colto healer tank things. So if somebody gets too low of health, one of us will hopefully go trigger it before they die. Just like that person did. Now those are little ad mobs. I don't have to worry about them up here. I want to say if you target it and hit it, they will swarm to you and blow up like suicide droids. Well, there's the first boss down. Now you notice there's a purple light coming from it. You get items. Unfortunately, since I'm a non-subscriber, I can't really use them. So I'll normally just sell them or put them on the Galactic Trade Network for other player characters to buy. One of the downfalls of not being a subscriber. If I am in the storyline and it feels like the story is actually getting too difficult for me, a lot of the times I will do a couple flashpoints here and level my character up. And it really doesn't take too long to level up a character at all doing these flashpoints. And they're kind of fun. If you get with a good group. Luckily, everybody I'm with is actually level 70. So we're just flying right through this. Now they'll probably pull back to here, pull the mobs back to here just so we can get them all grouped together again. No, looks like we're just good. No, there we go, yeah. Okay, we're pulling. It doesn't look like it worked out too well though. That's alright, we'll still take them all out. I like that little monkey lizard that person has. It's a pet. It doesn't do anything. It just, for appearances. Now that person just was able to activate this elevator using a splice skill. It's a crew skill that you can get from your station, your that hub where everybody meets up. And where the Galactic Trade Network kiosks are. There's different crew skills you can get. As a non-subscriber, you can only have one crew skill activated at a time, and I think if you activate another one, you lose the ability to use the one that you had previously, and I think you might have to start it all over again and build the levels back up. If you did choose to change it. Kind of sucks, but, you know. If you want more than one skill, become a subscriber. Yeah, ScareBanks leading the way. This is going to be our second boss fight of this mission.
Do you think it will fall to a single strike team? Your arrogance.
Normally we take out the two guys on the sides before we attack the main person. Now it's just a matter of spamming our attack skills to take them down. Vorgan the volcano. That battle was pretty straightforward, not too many tricks involved in it. I always choose to sabotage here. It's considered evil, but they're my enemies. Now once we attack these guys on the left here, that door in front of us will open up and some robots will come out. So that's why they're all over there. There's some pretty decent teamwork on this mission. I've seen a lot of people hover around like that. I think that's pretty cool. It's probably another subscriber-based thing. On group missions like that, a lot of the times if you get an item with the green light that drops, it will kind of go up for a raffle on who gets it, and you can click whether you actually need the item or whether you want it because you're being greedy. Most of the time people will select greed, but I believe if you select need, you'll have a higher priority and a higher chance of getting that item. Most of the time here, somebody will disable one of the guns, like that just happened, and everyone will attack the one that is not disabled. Man, he's taking me down fast. I might have to hide. I'm trying to put up my shields and stuff, but it doesn't seem to be helping too much. Yeah, I'm just gonna kinda hide over here for a second. Try to heal a little bit. Let somebody else get the Argo. Aggro? What is? That's two levels gained so far.
assigned to all personnel.
This bridge we're walking over will turn red when some energy flows through that tunnel, and it will actually disappear. I think it was the first time I was on this flashpoint. It disappeared with me on it, and I ended up dying. There was that group loot back there I was telling you about. I selected greed, of course, because I didn't really need it. Here's another one.
Hounds of the Empire! All that power, yet you still fear us!
And this is our final boss fight. If you get too close to the edge while fighting him, he'll blast you back and you can actually get knocked off of the edge and die. If you die during a battle, you can't come back, like in respawn. You have to wait till the battle's over or everyone dies.
I am a battle lord of the Advos Hegemony. You will fall before me. Your weakness is in your blood.
This boss will actually summon other people to come help him fight too. A lot of people who have some kind of AoE blastaback skill will knock them off the ledge as soon as they get here. But I'm letting the level 70 guys deal with him. I'm just going to keep spamming damage onto this guy.
Your weakness is in your blood.
Oh, I didn't even realize somebody was taken down. If I would have realized, I tend not to pay attention sometimes. I would have hit one of those cult toe healing machine things. Well, my inventory's full, so I can't get the item that was dropped, but I'm not going to be able to use it anyway, so it's no big deal.
Inoperable. Recommend immediate evacuation.
Now it's time to leave this part of the flashpoint. Gonna go over here to this holo terminal and talk to Doth Malgus.
Lord Malgus, Hammer Station has been destroyed.
I have seen the reports. You faced formidable opposition. The Supreme War Master of the Advisor Hegemony has offered his life in reparation for his people's misdeeds. The Advisec will never again pose a threat.
I've had way tougher jobs.
You may also wish to hear that intelligence has decrypted the station's data. We know how the Advisor Hegemony obtained a Republic superweapon.
Neste ahoje hatal al alasonak uraban. Folio semisem, ugin is it key?
It was Republic incompetence, not malice, that resulted in the Advisec's rise to power. There is a lesson in that.
When the galaxy learns that the Republic is responsible for every death Hammer Station caused, the Republic will face an uprising.
And they will grow weaker until we strike again. You may return to your duties, but know that you have done well. You may be called upon again.
And that's the Hammer Station veteran flashpoint. Let me know what you think. Maybe I'll do some more throughout the main mercenary storyline. Next video will be part of the actual story arc. Till then, I'll see you next time.